Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. I shall discuss column rebar lapping details. Please watch, and if you like, you can subscribe and press the bell icon. Let us start now. We always get to see the poor lapping arrangements of column reinforcement, either due to poor understanding or lack of communication between the bar benders, and primarily we should avoid such mistakes. Let me explain now the lap zone in the column. Before which, let me tell you the content in this section. So, like I have given typical section details where the column lapping can be done, which is a lap zone and which is non-lapping zone. And also, it is very important to read the notes in the drawing. Some of the notes are also been incorporated here. So, what is the grade of concrete in beams and slabs? What is the lap length? And other important details such as cover and etc. will be always given in the notes. So, we must always read the notes before taking it for execution. Some of the important tips are covered for the column reinforcement. And also stirrup details at junction, sectional detail is given. And the spacing of stirrups in the junctions of beam, slab is important, and which will be detailed in the drawing and in the section. Also given the formula for the calculation of the cut length of the stirrups. So let us go into the typical section for lapping details of the columns now. This is a typical section of a column reinforcement arrangement. We can see the lapping zone and no lapping zone. You can see the two full floor details, like it is 50 centimeter above the floor level is a no lapping zone. Similarly, from bottom of the beam, roof beam, 50 centimeter is a no lapping zone. Now, generally the floor to floor height is 3 meters, then it is about 1.5 meters, 50 centimeters a beam depth, and 50 centimeters a known lapping zone, and from slab top it is again 50 centimeters. So it is about 1.5 meters, so lapping zone available will be about 1.5 meters. So this is how it is. The lapping should be staggered as given in the, shown in the drawing. And it is always important, 50% of the lapping should be maintained in one floor, and remaining 50% can be maintained in the other floor. So lapping has to be staggered, and it is 50 centimeters above the slab level is no lapping zone, and from the bottom of the beam again 50 centimeter is no lapping zone, and we must maintain the laps in the lapping zone, which is roughly about 1.5 meters is available. So the reinforcement has to be planned and arranged, cut length has to be arranged in such a way that it has to be staggered, and the lapping has to be planned. This is about the lapping for the column reinforcement. Notes are very important in the drawing, which has to be carefully read and to be understood and taken it for execution. Now I have taken a sample notes from the drawing and given details here. Primarily it's telling about the concrete mix of M30 and M25 for beams and columns. And the grade of steel mentioned is about Fe500. Also given the cover to the reinforcement, main reinforcement, footing, column, beam and RCC walls. So mainly footing is 50 mm, which is normally below the ground level. So generally water table will be there. So accordingly, minimum 50 mm has to be maintained for footing. And for the column, it is always 40 mm is to be maintained. For beam and walls, it is 25 mm. lap length given is 50 times the dia of the bore. So it is a general notes. Sometimes if it is specifically required, it can be discussed with the concerned structural engineer, where you can ask whether we can go for 40D in the case of columns, a compression member. So that can be always be guided by the consultant of the project. So it varies between 40D to 50D. Now what we see is now the typical section for stirrup arrangement details, and generally the stirrups arrangements spacing will be given, differential spacing will be given in the mid span and the junctions of beam and columns, and slab and column junction. So here it is very specifically given about 20 inches below the bottom of the beam up to the in the column, the spacing of 5 inches is given. And similarly on the column slab junction, it is 20 inches where 5 inches spacing is given. On the beams and column junction, similarly the spacing will be 5 inches and it is for about 2 feet, 24 inches is mentioned. So these are all the basic differences will be given and detailed in the drawing of differential spacing, whereas here the 5 inches spacing is given and generally the other areas it will be shown as 6 inches. However, you'll have to interpret with the drawings given to you, and it has to be followed accordingly. It is a general brief note for the junctions of column, beams and slabs. And this is about calculation of cut length of stirrups. So we have side AB. So generally this formula is taken as 2 into A plus B plus 2 into 10D. So 10D is the hook length. So two hooks are there, so 2 into 10D. So in order to precisely calculate for the bent up areas, so we have 1, 2, 3 90 degree bends, so it is 3 into 2D plus 135 degree we have 2 bends, so that is taken as 2 into 3D. So total, this is a general formula to calculate the cut length of stirrups, 2 into A plus B plus 2 times the hook length 10D. And we have 3 90 degree bends and 2 135 degree bends. So the cut length formula is detailed and it can be calculated depending upon the size of the beams. So we all are very familiar with this table. This is weight of steel bars per meter length. So there are various different diameters of bar is given, 8 mm, 10 mm, 12 mm, like that up to 32 mm dia, and weight per meter length of steel rods. We all know the density of steel is 7850 kg per meter cube, and to calculate the weight of steel bar is d squared by 162.3. So this is a basic information for the weight of steel rods. Some of the project photos are given, where now you can see this photo is about a grade beam and a column junction arrangements, where the stirrup spacings are closer in the junction of columns, and in the midspan it is slightly more spacing. So it is an illustration of the stirrup arrangements in the junctions and the midspan of beam and column junctions. Similarly, this is also again the other view of the beam and column junctions. Also, you can see the staggering of the lapping of column bars, and also it is almost kept in the midspan of the column for the lap zone. So all these photographs is basically to show you the staggered lapping arrangements and the stirrups spacing. Another view of the column where you can see the staggered lapping is done. Again, this lapping arrangement is kept 500 mm above the this thing slab top level. So thanks for watching. If you like it, please share and comment and subscribe the channel. Thank you.